everyone, it's me, Alex, and everyone's favourite bird, Archie. I'm really excited about today's video because I picked out 5 different Korean-inspired outfits. Now, I'm really interested to hear what you guys think, whether I actually nailed the Korean fashion sense or not. I looked at a whole bunch of pictures. I looked at, you know, K-pop stars. I looked at Korean magazines. I looked at Korean TV shows. I tried to put together 5 looks that I think are pretty distinctively Korean. So whether we're talking about chunky sweaters tucked into things, or maybe, you know, layering with long sleeve shirts underneath t-shirts, or turtlenecks under dresses and stuff like that. This is my interpretation of Korean fashion, and please let me know down below once you watch the video if you think that I actually nailed it. If you think I didn't, please let me know down below some, you know, classic Korean looks that you'd like to see me try and style. So today's video is brought to you by Unzzy. I think that's how you say it. You'd think that if a brand's gonna be giving me stuff for free, I'd at least learn how to say the name of the brand. I think it's Unzzy. Some people call it Unzzy, U-N-Z-Z-Y. So they've given me all of these clothes today in exchange for this video, and I'm really excited because I've worked with them before, and last time that they sent me stuff, I loved all of it. So the stuff in this video I think is so nice. I've tried to do this a little bit differently today. I'm gonna show you like the complete outfits. So we'll get straight into it and start off with number one, so you see what I mean about how I'm structuring this video. So the first outfit that I put together was a chunky sweater like this. It's like a It's not chunky, you know, it's a thin sweater, but it's got this sort of chunky kind of knit. This is really light, but very, very soft and cozy. And I've paired it with some jeans. Now, I know in Korean fashion, they bless you. They often pair sweaters with jeans. So I picked up these jeans that have little love hearts embroidered on them there. They're slightly high-waisted jeans. And I've paired it with some little booties and some socks as well. These jeans are $30. I really love the embroidery. They are, I believe, just one size though, so they didn't fit me in the best way possible. I tried to make it work when I put the look together, but for $30 for a pair of jeans, I think that's pretty reasonable. This sweater is $33, which I do think is a little bit much because it is quite light. You know, it feels relatively well made. It's obviously not a designer piece by any means, but I do think that $33 is a little bit much for this, for what it is. But I do adore the look of it, and I love the colors too. I think this color combination is absolutely stunning. These shoes, these are only $34, and these are so incredibly comfortable. I adore this big chunky heel. These feel really well made. I love the little laces. I really like these fine little laces. What, you like laces too, don't you? Little ankle boots like this look so perfect paired with jeans, and I just had to wear them with these cute little socks. These socks have a love heart cutout, and they were only $8, and they're really, really cozy. I tuck them down a little bit sometimes if I don't want to show off the love hearts, but you can pull them all the way up too. It just really depends on the length of your jeans. The next outfit I am a little bit sort of skeptical about. So this outfit was pretty simple to pair together because the dress and the top actually came as a set. This was a $40 set, and for what it is, I think that's very, very good because this turtleneck that it came with, this is beyond soft. Like, words can't even describe how soft this turtleneck is. I love when things are two-piece sets and they come with multiple items because you can break it up and wear it however you want. You don't have to pair the turtleneck with the dress that it came with. But the dress, oh my gosh, the dress is so heavy. It feels really, really luxurious, but the only problem with it is that the cups sit in the most unusual way. I don't know whether it's just because of the size of my chest or what, but it just wasn't really flattering at the top. But as an outfit as a whole, I do really, really like it. And for $40, this really beautiful thick dress and a turtleneck, totally worth it. But the dress is the tiniest little bit short. There's an issue that I always have because of my height and the length of my torso and everything. Dresses from Asian websites always seem to run a bit short on me. But I paired this one with this cute little bag. This is a peach bag and I adore it. It's so soft and squishy and lovely and adorable. And I also paired it with some peach earrings as well to match. But what are you doing? But this was $32. Now, I don't know if I think that's worth it or not because I didn't have to pay for it myself. I'm more than happy to rave about it. But I don't know if you'd want to pay $32 for a squishy peach purse. I feel like this could be something someone could DIY very easily. I have some really crafty subscribers. And in the past, I've picked up something and I've said, I think you could DIY this. And then the next day, people have sent me pictures where they're like, look, Alex, I made that bag that you showed. So I feel like this is the sort of thing where if you're a crafty person, you could probably make a big peach handbag like this. But if you have no creative talent like myself, and you're happy to spend $32, you would be very, very happy with this. It's so adorable. It doesn't fit a huge amount. It will fit your phone and some money and your keys, but it's just one of the cutest little purses ever. And I wanted to pair it with this outfit because the brown, it's, you know, not very pretty pastel, please, as far as I'm concerned, but adding this just brings my own personal style into it. I'm so hyped about outfit number 3. I gave you guys a little sneak peek a little while ago on my Instagram story, and I got so many people messaging me like, where's that top from? Where's the skirt from? Where's the long sleeve top from? Where are the earrings from? So I'm finally able to show you guys. So this one I put together because when I think of Korean fashion, I always think of how they layer their pieces. So they do like a long sleeve top and then a t-shirt and then a skirt. So, and also these earrings are BTS earrings. So to start off with, it's a t-shirt, which is a $26 t-shirt. It's a beautiful shade of purple. You don't think so? It's got this little design on it at the front here, which is like a moon, and it's got like the play button, and it says Walking on a Dream. Empire of the Sun, Walking on a Dream. I love that song. This color is my favorite shade of purple in the world. This long sleeve top, my K-pop fans will recognize this from the Blackpink video. I don't know how to say it, but it's something like dr 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 dr. Anyway, I think that perhaps it's Jennie wearing this, I can't quite remember, but this is definitely a copy. I believe that in their music video, the brands that they're wearing, they're very high-end brands, so this is probably just a copy. This is a $24 top, and I can't begin to explain how cozy this is. Nate? Come on, come here. So this one, I don't know exactly what this is made out of. It's kind of this like stretchy, almost feels like scuba material. It's quite thick. I wear this under so many different tops, but I wanted to pair it under the purple one because I thought that the purple with the white, and also the fact that there's little moons on this and there's a moon on the top, I thought it paired in really nicely. And to finish the look off is this incredible skirt. This is nuts. I adore this so much. This is a $32 skirt and worth every cent as far as I'm concerned. It's really intricate, so it's got a zip that goes all the way down the front. So it zips up at the front like that, and the zipper details, it's got this little sort of star in a circle on the zip there. It's also got these things hanging off it, which I believe is something to do with rave, I don't know, harnesses. I mean, at first I did think it could have been overalls, but I definitely don't think it's supposed to be worn as overalls. Having the short sleeve top and the long sleeve top tucked into this made such a good look, and I paired it with these earrings. Now it's funny, on the website, these are called personality earrings. These earrings are $20, which, can you pick that up for me? No, it's okay, you're allowed to, I know. He's never allowed to touch earrings. You wanna show? Okay, that's fine, I'll show them. So these are like BTS earrings. So I believe maybe someone in BTS wears earrings like this. They're asymmetrical, so for one ear, there's just like a single circle, and then the other ear, it's like a long one with a cross hanging off it. I love this sort of Korean-inspired jewelry. I think it's so cool. Really unique having two different shaped earrings. My only problem with it is that these do kind of irritate my ears a little bit. They're not silver. I don't know what the material is, but it tarnishes very easily and it makes my ears go a little bit green. And if you're sensitive to jewelry, these are not gonna work well for you. If I wear these for a full day, they do kind of end up hurting my ears a little bit. Great for the look. I would prefer it if they were sterling silver though, but you're not gonna get sterling silver for $20. So, you know, you win some, you lose some. This next outfit is absolutely adorable. These overalls are so gorgeous. They don't feel so nice. They do feel a little bit rough to touch. The texture isn't great, but I love the color. They're so cute. It's got a fake pocket. We know I hate fake pockets, but the overall look of these is so sweet. These were $32 and I think they're worth every cent because this is a very Korean look with these overalls. They love overalls in Korea. In Japan as well, they love them. And I paired it with this beautiful top here that actually has a crescent moon cutout as well. Now the cutout here, it's actually got plastic in it. So it's not just straight through to your skin. It's like slightly shiny. interesting. I wouldn't have minded if it went straight through to the skin. I don't know if the plastic kind of cheapens it a little bit, but I love the color of this, and it's a turtleneck, and I adore turtlenecks. Slightly stretchy too. This is a $34 top though, which I think compared to some of the other tops that I've seen, you know, like there was a two-piece set that was only $40, so it is a little bit much, but it's so cozy and so soft, and I do love it so much. So I paired that with the overalls, and I paired it with these crazy holographic shoes. People send me these shoes on Instagram constantly. They send me screenshots and they tag me in pictures of these. These are so, so cool. These are only $40. They do feel like they're worth $40. They don't feel, you know, it's not like a Nike pair of sneakers or anything. They're not the best quality, but look how cool they are. Look, it's iridescent. Or is it hollow? Hollow? Now I put this outfit together, but I did also decide to change out the sneakers for just some darker sneakers that I have from Pretty Little Thing. I just felt like the holographic sneakers, I literally just paired them with this outfit because I wanted to show them to you guys, but I feel like the more muted color sneakers definitely look better. But the holographic ones for $40, they're worth every cent. They are some of the coolest sneakers I've ever seen. Watch out with the sizing though. If you're an Australian size 9 or 10, the biggest that you're going to be able to get is a size 8. These are a size 8. My feet just squeeze into them a little bit uncomfortably. So sizing, if you have smaller feet, you'll be fine. And then the last look, okay, don't roast me. I had a vision, guys. In my head, I thought that this was going to be fantastic. I thought it was going to be so stylish, so adorable, so very Korean inspired. It ended up being a little bit mismatched and weird. Some of you guys might like it, some of you are gonna hate it. Please tell me down below. Feel free to roast me, feel free to take screenshots and put it on Twitter and be like, look at this pretty pastel, please, what was she thinking? In my head, it made sense, I swear. So this outfit is a shirt dress, which is very long and rainbow, and I couldn't actually tell from the pictures, but this has a zip that goes all the way along here, and it's really, really odd because I don't know why. I don't know the purpose of the zip. What is it for? Is it to have easy access to your boobs? Is it the breastfeeding dress? I mean, I don't know. This was $29. I think it's worth every cent because I love long rainbow t-shirts. I paired it with this cap. This hat was $20 and it's so cute. It's got little clouds all over it. I'm not the biggest fan of the shape of it. Like it's a bit, I don't know, it's not quite as flattering as some other caps that I have. I think definitely with my hair out, it looks a lot better. This came in different colors. I know there was a blue one, but the pink was just too cute to refuse. Oh, you can't eat that. You can't eat that. This is a $20 hat. I don't know if it's worth $20 or not. I mean, I think I've definitely spent $20 on a cap before, but I got a really nice pink cap in Japan for $10 that was so cute. So I don't know, tell me what you think. I also paired it with these rainbow shoes. These are so cool. I love these so much. There's so many little details on these shoes that are beautiful. They do have a very unusual name on them. Chao Bai, maybe, I'm not sure. Even the base of these shoes is cute. It's got pink and purple on the bottom. They're Velcro. So yes, you can show them that it's Velcro. So you can peel them off like that, so you don't actually have to do up any shoelaces because these shoelaces are elastic. These were $43 and I think they're worth every cent. They're so gorgeous. I also paired it with these socks. Now these are really sweet rainbow pastel socks. There was a pack of two, so you got four socks all up. It was $16 for these socks, which I think is all right for two pairs, and they're such that this rainbow, this pastel rainbow, is so, so beautiful. I love it. And I also paired it with this bag. I don't have the price of this bag in front of me right now, but I'll put it up on the screen. It's got this chunky chain here that Archie's so kindly pointing out. It's iridescent with glitter particles mixed in, and it says Breakout Girls, which totally sounds like a Korean girl group. I'm not sure if it is or not, but Breakout Girls totally sounds like Backstreet Boys. So yeah, this outfit I wasn't entirely sold on. In my head, it made perfect sense, but actually wearing it in real life, I don't know what I think about it. I think definitely my favorite outfit is the purple t-shirt with the moons and the black skirt. I adore that one so much. And even the first outfit too is really casual with like a knitted sweater and high-waisted jeans. I love that too. Do you really want to play with that, huh? Is that your new toy? I think this is Archie's favorite item for sure, this little handbag. So that's it guys, just a nice short video for you. Let me know what you think. Do you think that I did the Korean fashion thing well? If not, leave your suggestions down below. Tell me what you think is like quintessential Korean fashion. Maybe whether you think it's like different types of tops paired with different pants or what. If there's stuff that you see K-pop stars wearing that you really, really love, tell me below. I would love to do a video where I dress like K-pop stars for a week. That's definitely on the table. And I also have a big K-pop video coming up where I'm trying to like learn as much as I can about K-pop because I don't actually know that much. And while I was in Japan, I had the chance to meet some people that are K-pop experts. So if you're excited about those sort of videos, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Hit the thumbs up, hit the notification bell, follow me on Instagram, it's Pretty Pastel Please. So with that, I think you should put that down before you break it. Excuse me. It's gone now. I'm so sorry. So with that, thank you guys so much for watching and we'll see you next time. Mwah!